which is the aspirational India. I shall cover programs and plans related to agriculture, irrigation, and rural development. That's my first under the aspirational India theme. Second, wellness, water, and sanitation. That's a second under aspirational India. And the third is education and skills. I move to talking about agriculture, irrigation, and rural development. Our government is committed to the goal of doubling farmers' incomes by 2022. We have provided energy sovereignty through Kusum and input sovereignty through Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. We have provided resilience for 6.11 crore farmers insured under Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Focus on cultivation of pulses, expansion of micro irrigation through Krishi Sinchai Yojana have raised the self-reliance of the country. Provision of any annual supplement of the income to the provision of annual supplement of income to the farmer directly is done through PM Kisan. Connectivity through PMGSY Gram Sadak Yojana, financial inclusion has helped raise farm income. Prosperity to farmers can be ensured by making farm and farming competitive. For this, farm markets need to be liberalized. Distortions in farm and livestock markets need to be removed. Purchase of farm produce, logistics, agri services need copious investments. Substantial support and handholding of farm-based activities such as livestock, apiary, and fisheries need to be provided for. Farmers desire integrated solutions covering storage, financing, and processing and marketing. Adopting sustainable cropping patterns and bringing in more technology are integral to our plan. All this and more can be achieved through working with and in cooperation with the states. The following 16 action points indicate our focus. We propose to encourage those state governments who undertake implementation of following model laws already issued by the central government. My first of the action points, 16 action points, but the first one is to encourage those state governments who undertake implementation of following model laws which are already passed and issued by the central government. First, Model Agricultural Land Leasing Act of 2016. Model Agricultural Produce and Livestock Marketing Act of 2017. Model Agricultural Produce and Livestock Contract Farming and Services Promotion and Facilitation Act of 2018. So three model agriculture related laws we would like state governments to consider favorably. Second of the 16 action points, water stress related issues are now a serious concern across the country. Our government is proposing comprehensive measures for 100 water stressed districts. Our government is proposing comprehensive measures for 100 water stressed districts. Third of the 16, in the budget speech of July 2019, I have stated that Annadata can be Urja Data also. The PM Kusum scheme removed farmers' dependence on diesel and kerosene and linked pump sets to solar energy. Now I propose to expand the scheme to provide 20 lakh farmers for setting up standalone solar pumps. Further, we shall also help another 15 lakh farmers solarize their grid-connected pump sets. In addition, a scheme to enable farmers to set up solar power generation capacity on their fallow and barren lands and to sell it to grid would be operational. Speaker, sir, this is a major step forward in which We are saying that farmers, if they have fallow or barren lands, now will be helped to set up solar power generation units so that they can then sell that which is being generated, solar power, to the grid, and through the grid, having given the power, solar power from their barren land, they will be able to make a living out of their barren land also. Fourth of the 16, our government shall encourage balanced use of all kinds of fertilizers, including the traditional organic and other innovative fertilizers. This is a necessary step to change the prevailing incentive regime, which encourages excessive use of chemical fertilizers. So this is an important point, I'd like to repeat it. This is a necessary step to change the prevailing incentive regime, which encourages excessive use of chemical fertilizers. Honorable Speaker, sir, in Tamil Nadu, 1,000 years ago, and she had used every letter of the Tamil alphabet to teach children moral stories. Not stories, moral lines. Each line was only three worded ones. They were very simple ones. They are called Aati Chudi, written by Avaya. Whilst talking about effective use of land, taking care of your land, removing weeds, and making sure you tend to it properly, she had just used three words in a little sentence, which says it all. And that's exactly what our Prime Minister is aiming to achieve, so that the farm lands are used with proper manure, not excessive manure, and limited water to grow their grains. Bhumi Tiruthi Unu is the line from Aati Chudi, which was said by a saint poet, a woman called Avvayar. Bhumi Tiruthi Unu. First tend to your land, take care that you're not excessively leaving it, and then trying to take a crop out of it. So the fifth point out of my 16 action points. India has an estimated capacity of 162 million metric tons of agri warehousing, cold storage, repo van facilities, and so on. NABARD will undertake an exercise to map and geotag them. In addition, we propose creating warehousing in line with Warehouse Development and Regulatory Authority, WDRA, norms. Our government will provide viability gap funding for setting up such efficient warehouses in the block or taluk level. This can be achieved where states can facilitate with land and are on PPP mode. Sector. So this is very important. Point number 9 of the 16th. Horticulture sector with its current produce. It's a very important point, sir. Horticulture sector with its current produce of 311 million metric tons exceeds the production of food grains. Horticulture exceeds the production of food grains. For better marketing and export, we propose supporting states which, adopting a cluster basis, will focus on one product, one district, so that a high focus is given at the district level for products in horticulture to really gain that momentum. 10th of the 16 action points. Integrated farming systems in rain-fed areas shall be expanded. Multi-tier cropping, beekeeping, solar pumps, solar energy production in non-cropping seasons will be added. Sir, I had mentioned in my July budget, zero budget natural farming. That shall also be included in our activities. The portal on Jaivik Kheti, online national organic products market, will also be strengthened. So the next point, the 11th, financing on negotiable warehousing receipts, ENWR, has already crossed more than 6,000 crores. Financing on negotiable warehousing receipts. This will be integrated with e-National Agriculture Market, the electronics one.